I need to ask, we ran out of time. So I need to ask some black people questions. dumb questions.
Those are questions.
Mark, do you believe in gravity?
I do.
I wrote down a lot of good questions I want to ask you guys.
I do.
You believe in gravity.
I do.
And you believe that too, right?
Yes.
Will we need that for this? The flat earth?
Gravity?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
On the inside of the ball, the gravity would be in there to hold us.
Yeah, that with a combination of air pressure, which is a whole other thing.
He would just explain gravity operates by a different mechanism than what it would say to make a moon orbit around Jupiter. So right. We both agree there's gravity there. We would differ on the mechanism behind it.
Do you believe in aliens?
Not in that they came from Venus or Jupiter or Mars. I think that, are there things flying around there? Sure, why not?
So are the aliens here with us, or are they flying around?
That's a great question. That is, I think there's older versions of us. I think that, older civilizations, things that predate us. I don't think we're the first people to rent this apartment by a long shot.
And so are they out here, or are they in there?
Tough call. Some of them may be inside, some may be outside. I don't know. I'm really dying to know.
What do you say?
I would say, if God created this earth for us to be here, it's up to him to whether he did it somewhere else or not. So I don't know the answer to that question. I think it's a great scientific and a great theological question, though.
Oh, yeah. I was wondering, when I was going over this last night, I'm wondering, where are the aliens? Where are they? Inside here or outside?
Well,
I think there's a lot
from
inside.
One aspect, if there are aliens out there, traveling through space is a really hard thing. Space is really, really big.
But it's
Do you believe in aliens?
I don't know. Like I said, it depends on whether God created them or not.
But do you believe right now whether God, do you believe there exists?
If you press me, I'd say probably not.
I'm pressing you.
Okay, I would say no.
Oh, okay.
It wouldn't surprise me if God did it, but I'm going to say no. We're the only life in the
universe. And you say?
I'm saying there's other things, there's other civilizations, previous civilizations that there are remnants still lying around. So no, in that the aliens are not from another planet, they're right here with us.
So you're saying the aliens are human beings.
Our ancestors.
Who were here before us.
Yeah.
And they managed to get out of this ball?
I don't know. Maybe they did. Honestly, if it was me, though, if I was building it, I wouldn't let them out. I'd let them go underground.
I wouldn't let them out. So they may be under this earth.
Yeah, maybe. Sure.
So I got to ask something else. So you believe the aliens, our ancestors, maybe under this earth.
Possibly, sure. There's remnants of them all over. Sunken cities off of Japan, sunken cities off of India, Bimini Road, Bosnian pyramids, take your pick.
And what do you say to that?
I say humanity is very resourceful. We've built lots of things. And the earth changes while we're here. So
Mark, tell me one more time, why would people make up this lie that the earth is round? What would be the purpose if the earth is really flat?
It's not that they're making it up. All they're doing is keeping an existing secret, meaning it was built by someone or something. I will call it the divine. And all we did was, when we figured it out in 1960, we just figured it. It's like, you know what? We're going to keep this thing under wraps until we can figure out a way to give it to the public. And I think we're running into that right now.
How do you respond to that? Yeah.
I guess I would say, as I read scripture, I find that God reveals himself in the scriptures. As we read the Bible, we figure out truth about God. God's also revealed himself in creation. As we study creation, we see his glory revealed. He tells us to look to the heavens, they reveal his glory. And so I think what we find scientifically about how the world works, that it's a globe, and that really is the most consistent way to see how he's revealed himself throughout creation.
How are conspiracy theorist people created?
I don't know that they're created. And there's a part of me that, I'll be honest, I sympathize with you in this sense.
You feel sorry for him?
No. I relate to what you're thinking?
Right.
Whether that's empathy or sympathy, I forget which.
Sure. But, empathy, I think.
Fair enough. Yeah. But there's a lot of times where it's like, I've been told, and it's like, wait a second, is that really true? Mm. And I get that's the question you're asking in a lot of ways. And I think you're a little more drawn to think that there are conspiracies. But I think that is a God actually wants us to be asking, hey, what's going on here? What's going on? But he also, and this may sound like I'm going against you,
but he
wants us to be drawn to what is the data say, and let's live by whatever the truth is. And, I think what I would love to see is, maybe have a discussion of, say, what is it that we could actually measure that we would both agree on that might settle this, or at least lean it more heavily one way or the other? And maybe let's go out and do that so that we don't have to keep arguing, from where we're arguing a common set of data that we all agree what it means.
I don't know. He black.